My book is in France. It is called Il Profond Sommier. And it is the story of three siblings who go off and swim in a quarry, a lake that is supposed to be cursed. Their father has told them they are never ever to go and swim there, but they do because it is hot. It is the Mississippi Delta, which is one of the hottest places in the world, in my opinion. And they go off and swim, and two of the siblings leave one of the siblings and go to pick berries and go into the woods. And when they come back, their sibling has, the younger sister has disappeared. And they spend the rest of the novel and the next few years looking for their sister who has gone missing, and also their father who is missing as well. And that's kind of the genesis of the story, and it moves from there. There's a lot of hauntings and curses and spooky moments, but it is mostly a mystery where a young girl and her brother go looking for their missing sister. You know, they start in the Mississippi Delta, but they end up traveling to the Everglades, following the clues of where their sister and where their father might be. And the Florida Everglades are one of the few places, I think, in America where you can still disappear. It's a very sort of spooky, remote place, or it can be a very spooky, remote place. When I was writing the book, I actually went there and I went kayaking in the Everglades, which I used in this story. There's a really large portion of the story in which the protagonist, the narrator, takes a kayak out and ends up actually getting quite lost in the Everglades as she searches for her missing sister and her missing father. And it's a beautiful place, but it's also dangerous, and I'm drawn to places that are both beautiful and dangerous. I love a good bit of folklore, or a good bit of history that may not be true. I love it. And in Mississippi, in the South in general, I think there's this idea that places are cursed or that places are haunted. And there are a number of places like that, actually, in this area. There's one place called the Devil's Punch Bowl that I visited shortly when I was writing this book, that is thought to be cursed, thought to be haunted. And there are big peach trees that grow there, and no one will eat the peaches from the trees because they know that the soil is littered with dead bodies. It's a place where slaves were put into an encampment and died, and so no one will eat the peaches because of this cursed history of the place. So I'm fascinated by this idea that a place can be cursed. And one thing that I discovered in writing the book was that places are cursed because we do terrible things there, right? As humans, we make terrible, evil decisions, and then we decide that a place is no good. It was really an important part of the book, and it's something that fascinates me even now. So. I did not get lost, but I saw how easy it would be to get lost when I went kayaking in the Everglades. It's, a huge place with lots of little tiny islands that appear and disappear very quickly depending on the rising water. So the landmarks are always shifting and changing, and it's a very difficult place to get your bearings when you get a little too far out. I had a guide, so I had someone to take me through, but had I been all by myself, I certainly would have been lost. It would be easy to get lost.